Hey everybody, Joe Granatelli here. Today we're going to talk about installing the new Granatelli slip fit exhaust cutout with our electronic turndown and unique V-band connection that allows you to set the exhaust angle exactly where you want it. So let's take a quick look at the products and we'll show you what makes us unique. Again, we have our patented casting, which is threaded. It allows you to put that on there in the exhaust cutout. And when you set this, it allows you to set the angle exactly where you want using a V-band. So instead of being forced to use the 3-bolt flange, where you only have 3 distinct locations, this allows you to set a V-band and put it exactly where it needs to be. Another great product that we have here is we designed the system to be 11, it's 11 inches wide, so we know where to cut, but also we put it 9 1/4 on center. So the center from here and the center to here is exactly 9 1/4, 9.25. So we're telling you that when you do the installation to just cut out about 9 inches of exhaust pipe. And then, so now if you look at 9 inches, you'll see the 9-inch slips in there perfectly. And then we include with it the proper band clamp. The band clamp slips on there and it gives you an airtight seal, exhaust tight seal all the way around. So it's nothing but quality. Another quick note to talk about, as everybody's come to familiar with on Granatelli, is everything is a quick connect. So it's a nice quick slip connect. And then we give you the Granatelli heat shrink tube that goes over that, that makes it a weathertight connection once you do the installation. And to talk about our one-step brain, all of our systems come with a brain, and the brain allows, it's a one-touch button. So all you do is touch the button once to open it, and once to close it. You don't have to hold the button in order to get full open or full close. And that's a really great option because it prevents the valve from over opening and over closing, which is probably the number one failure issue of exhaust electronic cutouts, is that people tend to hold on the switch and they over open it and over close it, which ultimately taxes the butterfly. It's important that when we first install this in the car, that we assemble it one time so that we know when we're cutting it and installing it in the system, we want to make sure this valve has the proper clearance and that everything fits. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take our bolt and our lock washer and our flat washer, and I'm just going to quickly mock this up. So the bolt goes through, we take a gasket, take our valve, and we take our body. Oops, I'm sorry. Put our gasket on there, and then our body. And what that allows us to do now is that once we do the installation, we'll know, before we cut the pipe, we'll know exactly where we need to be. So I'm not putting a flat washer on this one right now. I just want to make sure that all my tolerances are where they need to be. So this is just a quick mock-up. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to pause this camera and we're going to go look under the car. We're going to see exactly how we're going to fit this. All right, so we have a nice clean piece of pipe here, and this is directly in front of the muffler and right after the catalytic converters. And what we're gonna do is, you'll see here that we wanna make sure that we can get our clamp in there. So when we cut this, we don't wanna cut it up here because we won't be able to get that slip clamp. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna install this right there, which for the case of this Nissan, it just happens to be about 5 inches behind this bracket. But in any vehicle, you just want to make sure you have a little bit of clearance in the front and a little bit on the back. So although this pipe measures 11 inches, unless you're going to shorten it, and the idea here is not to have to do any fabrication, you really need about 13 inches because you need to make up for the clamp area in the front and the clamp in the back. So when we install this right here, then you remember we talked about having this mocked up. You want to make sure that when you put the valve in, that the valve, that the body and the motor is not in the way. So now we're going to go back in here. We know we have 11 inches. We want to go 9 inches on center. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my first spot where I want it. So the first spot's gonna be right there, so I know I want this to be right there. So there's my imaginary line. That's gonna be my first cut line. And now all I need to do is go 9 inches back. So I'm gonna measure out another 9 inches, which is right there. And then I'm gonna cut this 9 inches. Okay, so what we've now done is we've now removed our 9-inch piece from the tube, and then you'll notice the 9-inch piece basically is that center section. So when we install this piece back in, it's gonna be a perfect fit. Okay, so next step we're gonna do is we're gonna install our clamp first. So you wanna get the clamp on there. You're gonna put the small side to the outside each way. We'll slip that out of the way. Next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna install our piece. So you'll notice how easy it just slides right on. All right, so now that we've got our position in here, we've got our clamps where we want them, we're gonna tighten the exhaust up, make sure it's nice and straight, but that it's not touching anything. Okay, we're gonna build this system. So we've got that in there tight. And next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna, again, position this where we want it. So we're gonna put our V-band clamp on and then our turn down. And then before we snug this down, before I make the tie, I'm gonna get the exhaust perfectly straight. So I got that in there straight, and then let's see, and then we'll position this where we want it. I guess it's just a matter of opinion. I kind of like it facing back a little bit. So I'm just gonna put it a little bit at an angle. And then this is a 13 millimeter or a half inch. So we're basically done down here with the installation. The next thing we're gonna do is it's gonna be simple wiring. Okay, so we've got the system installed. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna do the wiring. So you'll notice all of our connections are male, female. We give you this 15 feet of extension cable. So we'll get that going. We wanna slide over our heat shrink tubing. And then we're gonna connect the male to the female. Slide this over to the middle. And then we're gonna heat shrink that on, and that's gonna make a perfect connection, and it'll make it watertight. Next thing we'll do now is we'll simply run these wires so they're not anywhere to be seen, and we'll run this to the smart switch or to the brain, which needs to be mounted inside the car. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to run these wires the best way that I see for this application, but ultimately in the end every installation is going to be different. This video is intended to be a simple overview of how you install our flared bolt-in exhaust cutout with electronic valve. So you'll have to do this part of it yourself where it goes to the brain. Okay, so we've got the valve installed, we wired it. Open the valve, please. Okay, so what you'll notice here is you'll see there's a gate right there where, so when that butterfly closes, it rests on that shelf. So there's a half moon on this side, there's a half moon on the other side. That's how we get a perfectly tight seal. Close it. So when the exhaust is pushing, it's pushing against the outside edge to make a tight seal. Start the truck. And then we'll open it up. Open. So one touch, it's fully open and close. And then one touch, fully closed. Rev it up. Now open it. One more time.